Despite these huge blows to the enemy, the cooperation with the Americans, the introduction of Pathfinder aircraft, and the improvement of aircraft bomb sites, Allied losses continued to mount during 1942. In all, 1,400 aircraft were lost. Furthermore, the bomber offensive was placing a huge strain on the country's oil supplies, and although German High Command appeared to have been badly shaken by the bombing, civilian morale had not collapsed, and war production seemed unaffected. At the start of 1943, the Allied leaders held a conference in Casablanca where they agreed a number of decisive measures regarding the future conduct of the war. One was the decision to mount an intensive combined bomber offensive on Germany using the air forces of Britain and America. The region of the Ruhr received particular attention from the Allied bombers, and for a period of 4 months, this area was repeatedly attacked. These raids included the famous Dam Buster raids by Guy Gibson and 617 Squadron. As the attacks on the Ruhr were drawing to a close, a new intensified attack was about to be launched. The destruction of a whole city was now on the top of the Allied target list. To achieve this would mean the full weight of all Allied aircraft being used, and some new, innovative tactics would be needed to counter the threat of the German defences.